Hi guys, today I want us to look at some of the questions that you can expect in demand and supply. Let's look at the question below. It says that as an economics student, you have been analyzing the price movements of different products. You know the following two price relationships. A, when there's drought, the price of maize rises, and B, when the price of potatoes increases, the demand of bread also increases. Now, assuming that bread is a substitute for potatoes. The question says use demand and supply diagrams to explain these two relationships. Please note in B, two diagrams are required, one for potatoes and one for bread, and a detailed explanation. Now, when you come across such a question, and in this case, we have A and B. Now let's focus at A. A says that when there's drought, price of maize rises. So what are the factors that are we talking about in this scenario? Number one, it says that it's talking about drought, right? So now you have to consider a few things. So from the scenario that you are provided with, are you able to identify the factor that they are talking about that either influence demand or supply? And also determine whether that factor causes a shift or a movement, right? So remember in our notes, we say that there's only one factor that causes a movement along the demand or the supply curve, and that is the price of that specific product. So in this case, they are talking of drought. And if you can recall in our notes, we say drought is one of the factors that cause the supply curve to shift, right? Or it's one of the determinants of supply. So then you, if you know the factor that they are discussing in the scenario, it will be easier for you to understand the question. So in this case, our main focus is on drought. Right, so drought actually affects supply. So the producer of maize obviously will be affected. So, and you're saying that when there's drought, the price of maize rises. Well, so in this case, we are going to draw a demand and supply curve because that's what we are asked, but we are only going to change the supply curve because it's the one that influenced or affected in our scenario. Drought is a determinant of supply. Obviously, when there's drought, the producers will not be able to produce more. And if they are not able to produce more, obviously they will increase their prices in order to cater for the demand. Right. Let's go ahead and draw our demand curve. So the question is A, and you're asked to draw a demand curve. Right, so we're just gonna call it demand and supply curve, right? Curve for maize. Right, so we're just gonna call it demand and supply curve for maize. Then we have to draw our diagram. Right, so then we have quantity here. So this is Q. You can write quantity in 4, right down here. Right, then you have 0 here, of course. You have P for price, and you can also just write price in 4. Then you are asked to draw a demand and supply curve. So the first thing that you have to do is to make sure that you have your initial demand, which you can even call D0, D1, or anything that you want. You also have your initial supply, the one that you can call S0, S1, or SN. This is actually something that you can do immediately after reading the question. You don't have to understand the scenario to do this, but you actually have to do this first thing first. And make sure that if you are saying that this is D0, this should be S0 and this should be E0. And here it's what is stands for equilibrium, where actually quantity demanded is equal to quantity supplied. Then we have quantity 0. Make sure that they correspond, right? You cannot have D0 and quantity 1 here. It do not make sense. Then going to your left, you have P0. So this is your initial supply, initial equilibrium, initial quantity, so let's say initial price, right? So going back to our question, we say that when there's drought, the prices of maize rises. So in this case, we are talking of drought. What happens to our quantity supplied when there's drought? Our quantity supplied decreases, right? So meaning that the supply of maize will decrease because of drought in the market. So now we know that you're only going to change the supply curve because that is what is the scenario is about. And in this case, we are talking of a decrease in supply. So where do we shift our curve? You have to bring it to your left and you name it as 1 because it's your new supply curve. And this will bring us to our new equilibrium, which we can call E1, right? Then going down, we'll have quantity 1. And if you look down here, you'll be able to notice that your quantity supplied is decreasing. And that's the main purpose in this case, right? So obviously, this will have us to P1. And you can see that the prices of maize increases from P0 to P1, right? So this is actually how you solve your demand and supply curve. Now, you are not done. You still have to explain. So when you're explaining, it's best if you start with the factor discussed in the scenario. So you're going to say that the drought will cause a decrease in the supply of maize, the first point. The supply curve will shift from S0 to S1. The equilibrium will also move from E0 to E1. And make sure that you also indicate with your arrows. The quantity supplied, because we are dealing with supply, we are calling it quantity supplied will decrease from Q0 to Q1, and the price of maize will increase from P0 to P1. And there you are done. Right. So let's move on to the next question. The next question says, when the price of potatoes increases, the demand of bread also increases. Bread is a substitute of potatoes. Again, right, so we know that if you are talking of substitutes causes a what? A shift of the either supply or demand curve. But in this case, they said the demand of bread also increases, meaning that we are dealing with demand and not supply. So let's go back to our answer. So we can have our B here. Can just call it B. And remember, the question says you can have, it says that please note in B, two diagrams are required, one for potatoes and one for bread, and a detailed explanation. So that means that in B we'll have two diagrams, right? One for potatoes and one for bread. And it says in the question that there's an increase in the price of potatoes. Now, what will happen to the demand for potatoes if the price of potatoes increases, and how will that have an effect on the demand for bread? Right. So then we can draw our demand and supply curve for potato. Right. And again, the concept is still the same. Okay, let me just say potatoes. Right. So then we have our diagram. Again, this is kill, and this is 0. We have P this side, right? And you can draw our initial demand, our initial supply. Then we have, just in the middle there, we have your initial equilibrium. Then going down, we have our initial quantity. Going this side, we have our initial price. And again, it's up to you. When you're drawing your initial supply demand equilibrium and quantity as well as price, you can name it anyhow you want. You can say 0 or start with 1. So in this case, I'll just leave it blank. Right, so once you have your initial supply, initial demand, initial quantity as well as your initial price, then you can go back again to your scenario and try to understand it. Right, so we are dealing with two products here. The first product is potatoes, and we also have bread. And you're saying that the price of potatoes increases, and potatoes can be substituted with bread, meaning that if potatoes are expensive, I can actually just buy bread instead of potatoes. So now what will happen to the demand for potatoes? Because you're saying that the prices of potatoes increases, that means that customers will demand less of potatoes. And that's according to the law of demand. When the price is high, the quantity demanded is low. And when the price is low, the quantity demanded is high. So in this case, our demand curve, or our demand is actually going to decrease. Now, so if your demand is decreasing, you put your demand curve down there. So, and we can name our second demand curve D1. Then this will bring us to a new equilibrium, right? Which is E1. It will also bring us to a new quantity, which is Q1, and we have new price, which is P1, and also indicate that the demand curve shifted from D to D1, quantity demanded decreases from Q to Q1. Now, you might be wondering why I'm saying quantity demanded and I was saying quantity supplied in our previous demand and supply curve. So in this case, I'm saying quantity demanded because you are dealing with demand. And if you are dealing with supply, you say quantity supplied, right? And you can see that the price would decrease from P to P1. So in this case, when you are done with your diagram for potatoes, all you have to continue with is again what? The explanation. So in explanation, you are again going to start with the factor. So you are going to say that an increase in prices of potatoes will cause a decrease in demand for potatoes. So the demand curve will shift from D to D1. The quantity demanded is going to decrease from Q to Q1. The price is going to decrease from P to P1. And equilibrium is going to move from E to E1. Then you are done with this part. Right, so we are still halfway the question. Let's look at another diagram, as we are instructed to have two diagrams. So in this case, we have another diagram, which is for bread. And we are told that bread is a substitute for potatoes. So now what happened if you can substitute potatoes with bread? You go to Pick and Pay today. You find out that the price of potatoes is high, but you can actually replace potatoes with bread. So what you do, you buy bread instead, which is affordable. So that's what you are going to look at. So we have your initial demand. We have your initial supply. We have our initial equilibrium, and we have our initial quantity, and we have our initial price, right? Then it says that Bread can be substituted with what? Potatoes. Meaning that if the price of potatoes is high, customers are going to come and buy bread. What will that do to our demand for bread? Of course, the demand for bread is going to increase because customers are moving from potatoes, which are expensive, to bread. So now then we have a new demand curve, which we are going to call D1. We also have a new equilibrium right here, which we are going to call E1. Then you also have a new quantity, which we are going to call Q1, and we'll have a new price, which we are going to call P1. Right. And you just indicate with your arrows that the demand curve will shift from D0 to D1. The quantity will increase from Q to Q1, and the price will also increase from P to P1. And again, you are asked to explain the diagram. So you are going to say that an increase in the price of potato, which is a substitute of bread, will cause an increase in the demand for bread, right? The demand curve for bread is going to shift from D to D1. The quantity demanded for bread is going to increase from Q to Q1, and the price is going to increase from P to Q1. The equilibrium is going to move from E to E1. Then you are done. As simple as such. So the trick here is that make sure that you understand the scenario. Identify the factor that is being discussed in this scenario. Find out whether it affects supply or demand, right? And of course, if it find out whether it's going to increase or decrease supply and or demand. Right. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll see you again in our next video.